Hi there. Come on in. I had a feeling I might see you today. You've become rather famous around here. Talk of a mysterious stranger passing through. And the rumour is you're heading west. Is that right? Well, only the bravest of us head west, and nobody heads anywhere without first taking a trip to the trading post. And here you are. But you're very welcome. So here are the rules for this particular trading post. You'll begin by showing me the items that you have to trade, and I will decide if they are worth trading for. If they are, I'll show you some items and you can decide what you like and what you don't like. How does that sound? Do you have some items to trade? Do you have some good items to trade? Okay, great. Well, let's begin then. Let's see what you've got. Handy in the backpack. That's great. Thank you very much. Are you looking to trade the backpack as well? No. Okay. It does look like a decent, sturdy backpack. But everything in here is for trade, is that right? Okay. Let's take a look at what you've got. Now this is interesting. This is very interesting indeed. I can't remember the last time I saw one of these. This is military. And it's new. Are you military? Okay. Were you in a fight? Tell me, is it damaged? Or is it intact? Looks pretty good to me. To tell me how you came by it? Just wish to continue being a mysterious stranger. Well, I will absolutely trade you for this. 100%. Let's carry on. Oh. Is this a joke? I hate to tell you, but your money is no good here. How much is here? I can't remember the last time I saw currency, and I certainly can't ever remember seeing this much. How much is here? I'm thinking what? $10,000 here easily? Have you been anywhere that's accepted currency? Oh, wow. For as much as this is no use, I'm almost tempted to trade for the novelty value, for the nostalgia. I may count it first, but That's a lot of money. Care to tell me how you came by such a large amount of currency? No, I didn't think so. I tell you what, I'll trade you for it. I like it. I haven't seen money for a very long time. So what else do we have? One more thing. Is this real? This is an awful lot of ammunition. How much is here? And you want to trade it all? How come? Ah. You have the bullets, but not the gun. I see, well. Worthless to you in that case, however. Extremely, extremely valuable to me. I will absolutely trade you for all of these bullets. Just put those down there for now. That is my most precious currency. I have to say, it gives you pick of almost anything at the post. Is it items that you're looking to help you as you travel west? Okay, well, I'll show you a variety of items that I have available for trade. Some which will be of a definite help, and some which might just assist with comfort and things like that. But you can take your pick at the end. You're ready to get started? Okay. The first thing that you will absolutely need on your way west is a gas mask. Do you have one? No, well, 100% you will need one of these. This one has brand new filters and it's only lightly used. I can't say it's new. What is new these days, right? But this will absolutely help you where the air is no good. And there is a lot of that west. I know one or two who have been there, one or two who have tried to, let's say, break through. But they absolutely needed their gas masks along the way. Would you like to take a look at this one? Try it on? Yeah, take a look. It's good for two things, really. Firstly, it's good for the bad air. It will keep you safe. But secondly, I'd keep it on for as long as I could. It will be good for anonymity. Thank you. So what do you think? Useful? On the yes pile, the maybe pile? You can decide later. Okay. Whilst navigating west, do you have a torch, flashlight, anything like that? Well, I have a rather good one here. It's good for several reasons. Firstly, it is magnetic. So, we'll come on to this later. You can use the magnet. Also, it is telescopic. And it can help you to see around corners, see into tight spaces, and things like that. Also, and one of its greatest points, it is very, very bright. Would you like to see? Ready? Very, very bright indeed. So as I said, for looking around without it being too big and bulky in that backpack, having a good look around, perhaps looking around corners, perhaps needing to look ahead of you without necessarily going forward yourself. It's a very versatile, bright piece of equipment. What do you think? Sorry, did I dazzle you? Small, but very, very mighty. What do you think? Okay. Have you thought about food and drink at all? I know that most of our food these days is field fresh, but if you're heading west, you might find that one or two nights you are indoors for a fair amount of time. I do have a can of food here, but it is a mystery surprise. When's the last time you had any food from a can? Long time ago, right? Well, it's up to you if you'd like to take a roll of the dice on this one. Perhaps don't look at the expiration date on this. But it sounds liquidy, so how bad can it be? And also, as an added benefit, when you've eaten, you'll also have a can for storage. It's a nice, easy ring pull, so you won't need to worry about how difficult it is to open. What do you think? Surprise can? That sounded like a maybe. And what about water? How do you carry water? Do you have a decent canteen? Okay, well, how's this for a treat? I have a brand new canteen. It holds 2 litres of water, so you'd only need to fill it once a day. And also, it comes with its own filtration system. So if you can't immediately reach clean water, any water will be good in here. Take a look. Just inside. See? Brand new. Comes insulated. It also has a pouch at the front for additional filters or anything you care to carry, and it can either attach to a belt or you could clip it to your bag, or you could simply carry it. Although I would recommend keeping your hands free once you are west. When's the last time you had something new? I can't remember the last time I had anything new. But there we go, so a new canteen. Can't hurt, right? What do you think? Okay, sounds good to me. Next, how are you for medical equipment? I have a few pieces of medical equipment here that might be useful to you. You look fit and healthy at the moment, despite the fact that you may have seen some action recently. Okay. Even if you have medical equipment, I would certainly suggest you take some more heading west. I'll show you what I have. Firstly and most importantly, I have some sterile wipes. You have to be very, very careful these days because grazes, scrapes, cuts, bruises, things like that can get infected very quickly. And you know that these days, infections are not good. Infections can be extraordinarily serious indeed. So the best place to start is by giving them a wipe. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 available. You're welcome to all of them. I would suggest that these are a very good first line of defence. And heading west, you're likely to be tackling some, well, challenging terrain. And therefore, I'd imagine you'd get through these pretty quickly. I also have a selection of gauzes, self-adhesive dressings and standard dressings from the very small up to the rather large. Once again, if you find yourself with any nasty cuts, if you find yourself on the wrong end of a fight, or worse, the wrong end of a bullet perhaps, it's very important that you get those things covered straight away because of those aforementioned nasty, those infections that can occur. So I have 2 very large dressings here. What you would do is pop them straight over to keep them away from any of the nasties, especially if you're in an area of bad air. Then there are some medium-sized ones. Again, not paying too much attention to the expiration date on them. A very small one, which could be useful for the face, the hand, places like that. And also 2 adhesive ones, so like plasters, but much thicker. So rather than worrying about having to attach them, straight on, and off you go. With these, I do have some tape, so you'd just be able to peel the tape back, like so. Tear off what you need, and then the dressings on there. I also have 2 bandages. The first one is a very old bandage. However, medical equipment is medical equipment these days. And what I will say about it is clean. It hasn't been used, and I store them very carefully. So it's still a very useful piece of kit. I also have 1 more bandage, which is still in its pack. Again, pay no attention to that expiration date, but this is perhaps as sterile as it gets. And this says it is a large dressing. So again, very useful for all sorts of injuries. What do you think to this one? Well, what do you think to all of the medical equipment? Yeah, it should always be a very definite yes, I think. Okay. So next, when you're heading west, I assume you have a gun with you. How are you planning on breaking through the various areas that I assume you're heading to? Okay. You potentially lose any knives at checkpoints, but I do have a blade here, and it's not all that pretty, but it is very sharp. And it can be used for all sorts of things. getting into things, getting out of things. Multi-purpose, utility. Would you like to take a look? Again, it's something small that will fit into the bag, and although not pretty, it can be very useful. What do you think? Thank you. The other thing I have, which we saw earlier, is this. Doesn't look particularly special. However, when unwrapped, it can be used like a saw. If you're sawing through wood or something like that. Very handy piece of equipment. Again, if you're looking to get into somewhere, if you're looking to get out of somewhere, if you find yourself in a spot of bother perhaps, again, a tool with many uses, and I'm not going to ask what you might use it for. However, a very useful compact cutting tool. Take a look. Yeah, so rather than having to carry a large saw in that bag, potentially getting it confiscated or stolen, it's very compact indeed, could fit in the pocket, and is quite safe until it's being used. Thank you. Yes, this is a handy piece of kit. A couple more things for you before it's time to decide. Just for that journey west, do you have a compass at all? With that air and the long periods potentially in the gas mask, it is quite easy to become disoriented and lost. This one has a compass, and there's west. It's telling me that west is that away. It is quite right. It clips around the wrist, but it has one or two other fun little functions. So there is a can opener, which you could use for this, should the ring pull not work, and a serrated edge. So a small blade for anything that you need. Bottle opener if you happen to find some beer. If you do bring it back, I'll trade for it. And this side has a flint. So if you're stuck on lighting a fire. However, I would potentially recommend against lighting fires when you're heading west. What do we think to this little clip? Take a look. Okay. Again, as it fits around the wrist, you shouldn't notice it. It's not something that you have to carry or store. And it's very handy, should you need it quickly. Thank you. Okay. The final thing I have for you is a weapon. And I would ask you to consider this very carefully. I have heard a lot of stories from the West, people who have been, people who have returned, and the stories they return with suggest it is an arduous journey indeed. And before you get to where you are heading, there are many obstacles in the way. It might well be at some point that one of these will come in handy. Once upon a time, I had 6 of these, and this is my last one. The other 5 all headed west. But hey, it's not for me to try and put you off. Have you handled a grenade before? You know what to do. Pull the pin. Once you've pulled the pin, you have a few seconds to throw it and get as far away as you can. I think this will be very handy for if you need to clear an area very quickly to give you passage through to where you're going. Also, you won't need to waste any of your ammunition. Take a look. I think that they seem quite scary the first time you handle them, but as you go, it should get a little easier. Thank you. Don't be scared of this. This may well be your best friend. So, it's make your mind up time. You have here an empty backpack. Let's see what you'd like to fill it with. Okay. So where did we begin? So, food and drink. Like to take a gamble on the canned food? See? What can it hurt? You may find yourself trading it. And what about the brand new canteen? Yes. I think a very useful addition to your equipment. The medical equipment, you're going to take that, yes. All of it. Yeah. So, the antiseptic wipes in there. And then the tape. The large dressing. The bandage. The adhesive dressings. And the small, medium and large ones, yes. Okay. That's great. The sawing tool. Fantastic. Oh, might need to repack this. The compass. The blade. The torch. Well, this does have the batteries in it. Once the batteries run out, you'll need to source some more. However, there are many trading posts between here and your destination. The gas mask. Is full again. Let's just put this over for you. Would you like the grenade? I think that's very wise, but I'm not going to put that in the backpack. I'm going to hand that to you if that's okay. Take very good care of that. And here are all your items. There you go. Well, thank you very much for visiting the trading post today, mysterious stranger. And I wish you all the very best on your journey west. What I will say is, if you are successful and you find yourself back this way, then please do come and see me again. Because I feel like the next time I see you, you might have some very interesting things indeed to trade. But best of luck to you. And stay safe. See you soon.